So here we have the question. So here several members have not got, I think. The sixth one problem I will solve later. Okay, sixth one problem, the homework problem, so I will solve it later. Because you have already have done, I think. Yes, you have already done. So we will go by the third, fourth, fifth, and then we will go for the sixth one. Third question here. Okay, let it be. Now you can see, now you can check everything is proper. Yes, you can see the screen. Yes, yes. So see a third question. Find the number of whose sum is, find the two numbers. You have to find the two numbers and sum is 27, it seems, and the product is 182, it seems. So there are two numbers. Question is correct. Yes, yes. Question is correct. Find the two numbers whose sum is 27 and the product is 182. So here you can see solution. So we don't know the two number. Let first number is equals to x and second number is equals to y. So this is like a linear equation. Well, I'm saying that quadratic equation and linear equation are not different. Both are same. But quadratic means only one variable, linear means two variable. That is the only one difference you have to remember. So now we have to eliminate here x or y. So we will take the first one statement. So they have told that sum of the two numbers. So by statement, sum of the two numbers are x plus y. Sum of the two numbers is equal to 27. So we have to write on x plus y is equal to 27. Now we have to see which one you want to eliminate, whether you want to eliminate here x value or you want to eliminate the y value. It is left to you. You can eliminate anything, but maximum we will eliminate the y. So we will eliminate the y. So let us eliminate this y. For that purpose, I will keep that y here only. I will shift that x on the other side. So 27 will remain as it is. This x I will shift because I want to eliminate y. So it is minus x. Okay, 27 minus x is nothing but the y value. This is the most important step. So y value is nothing but 27 minus x. So here we got the two numbers. One is x and one more is 27 minus x. So this is the first step we have to do. So by statement, second statement we have product is 182. Russell, answer me, what do you mean by product? Russell, answer me quickly, what do you mean by product? Without wasting the time, answer to me, what do you mean by product? Russell, you are here. You can know product means you don't know. Mute, you can take it down and you can answer it to me. You can take out the mute and you can answer it to me. Unmute that and answer it to me. Product means you forgot. The product. Okay, multiplication. Yes, we have to multiply that. That is called the product. So product are nothing but the two numbers we have to multiply. That two numbers are x into y. The two numbers are here. I have taken as x and one more is y. We have to multiply them. That is x into y. That is equals to 182. So here we have taken x as it is. But y I can write it down as what? 27 minus x. So here I have to take that instead of y. I have to take down 27 minus x. That is equals to 182. So next is the multiplication. So how many of you have doubt here? You can ask me. Quickly you ask me if you have doubt. Till here if you have doubt, ask me. The first statement is finished. Second statement we have taken the product of the two numbers. So those who have doubt, ask me. Otherwise you type me no. So that I can go further. No doubt. Okay. Then we have to multiply this x with the 27x with the x. So x into 27 is 27x. X into minus x is minus x square. X into x is minus x square. So minus we have. That is equals to 182. So we have to write in terms of. First I will write on minus x square. Because x for highest power you have to write on first. Then 27 is a positive value. And 182 I will bring on towards the left. So it will become 1 minus 182. That is equals to 0. So this is the first equation what we need that we have found. But actually here the equation in that the minus must not have this x value, x square what we have, that must have the positive value. So this sign what I have here, that is along with the x, that is negative, I will change. If one sign if you change, all the signs you have to change. So here what will happen, that x square will be positive, that plus 27 will become minus 27x and the minus 182 will become plus 182. That is equal to 0. Those who have doubt till here, ask me quickly without wasting the time. Quickly, how to ask me the doubt if you have no doubt. Okay, only Trisha. Okay, all of you are saying that no doubt. Okay, I will tell you. So here you can see they have given a sum. They have given the sum. One second. Okay. They have given the sum of the two numbers are 27. So I have taken here x plus y is equal to 27. One number I have taken x, second number I have taken the y. I want to eliminate the y. So I will keep that y here only and I will shift this x on the other side. It will become minus x. It will become what? Minus x. So 27 minus x is the y value. That y value I will substitute in place of y. That is the product of the two numbers are 182. Product is nothing but multiplication of the two numbers. We have to multiply the two numbers. What they have given, that we are multiplying. So x into y. So x as it is I have written, but the y value what I have, that I found as what? Y is equals to 27 minus x. So that 27 minus x I have written here. I have written that 27 minus x I have written as it is in place of y. Then I have multiplied this x with this 27 also and minus x also. So x into 27 is 27x. X into minus x is minus x square. That is equal to 182 as it is. Then I have brought this 182 on the left hand side. When I brought the 182 on the left hand side, the positive 182 will turn to minus 182. Lastly, the x square must not have that negative symbol. So here we have negative symbol. No? That negative symbol must not have. Here it is plus actually. Okay. So it negative symbol we have not supposed to have. So I will change this negative symbol. When you want to change one any symbol, so all the symbols you have to change. So if you want to change this minus into positive, so here I am making positive. So everywhere I have to change the symbol. So that is the equation we found. So till here, those who have doubt, ask me. I think you understood, Russell. Doubt? Doubt. Quickly, you have a doubt? No. Okay. So next step is of splitting the term. So x square minus 27x plus 182, that is equals to plus 182, that is equals to 0. That is the equation, the splitting the middle term. So here we have to split the middle term very importantly. Okay. Okay. Here when you are splitting the middle term, I will take a little bit on the right hand side because I don't have a space. Okay, I will take this much is enough. So when you are taking to the this one left hand side, sorry, splitting the term, you can see here this when you will add, you must get the 1 minus 27, and when you will multiply, you must get how much? 182 into x square, that is 182 x square. You must get what? Positive 182 x square. What are the two numbers now? What are the two numbers? When you will add, you must get minus 27x. And when you will multiply, you must get 182 x square. What are the two numbers now? Yes, here the two numbers are also negative because the positive value I got here. When you will multiply, you must get positive means both the numbers must be positive or both the number must be negative. But here we have the negative 27, so both the number are negative. So both the numbers are negative means you must remember the numbers are nearby number. Yes, that is 13 and 14. But how to find that? If you want to ask means 182, you have to prime factor it. 2 9s are, 2 1s are. Next, you can go with the, okay, 182, no, 9s are, 1s are. Then you can go with the 7 on the table. Again, you can't go anywhere. So 7 ones are, only 7 ones are, 7 threes are, then 13 ones are. So here we have 2, 7 and 13. So 2, 7 one group I will do and 13 I will take one group. So 14 and 13, when you will multiply, you get 182. When you will add them, so 14 plus 13 is 27, but negative sign, so both the numbers will have the negative symbol. So here it is 14x and one more is 13x. So this is the way how to find this, yes, factorizing. So now x square I have to write down as it is. This minus, I will write down here 14x minus 13x. What I have did is 27 I have split it into two terms. So plus 182, that is equals to 0. So next thing is grouping. Grouping is here simple, that x value I have to group it separately, because here the x is having the common. So here left is x and here it will be minus 14, because I have taken that x common. So similarly here the negative symbol will be also negative only. So here very importantly, inside I must have x minus 14, yes. So outside I have to take the 13 common. So 13 into x is 13x, 13 into 14 is nothing but 182, just now we found that. So yes, so that is equals to 0. So this is most important part. If you have not understood this, ask me quickly. Understood? So next step is this x minus 14. X minus 14 is simple, that x minus 14 you can write on one side, and on another side we have x and minus 13. X minus 13, that is equals to 0. So x minus 14 is equals to 0, and or x minus 13 is equals to 0. So these are the two numbers. So x is equals to 14 we got, and one more we have, that x is equals to 13. So which answer is correct? Which answer is correct? Whether x is equals to 14 is correct or x is equals to 13 is correct? Here both answers are only correct, because here if you are taking that x is equals to 14, one more answer, that is y value, if you are want to find 27 minus x, that is nothing but 27 minus 14, that is equals to 13. So you got one more value as 13. And if you want to find that x is equals to this one, 27 minus x, we have 27 minus the x value, now here is 13. So then also you are going to get the 14 only. See, it is vice versa. Both the answers are correct. 14 also correct answer, and 13 is also correct answer. So here this is the answer. So any difficulty you have, you can ask me. This is no need to find also. This is no need to find. Because in a quadratic equation, remember, in quadratic equation, you are going to find the value directly. You are going to find, have the value directly. No need to substitute for the y. No need to substitute for the y. Because you have to substitute for the y only in what? Linear equation. Only in linear equation you have to substitute for y. Here no need to substitute for what? Y. Because you have taken in terms of one variable. You have eliminated already y, no? So for that purpose. So those who have doubt, ask me quickly. If you have a doubt, ask me quickly. It is not difficult. Only one thing is difficult over here is to make that question into state this one. Number form. That is equation form. No doubt, yes. So let us move with the fourth question. Let us move with the fourth question. Okay. So how much is possible today, I will complete quickly, because next I will give the introduction. Okay. Now coming back to the fourth question, here the fourth question we have, find the two consecutive positive integers, the sum of whose squares is 365. Remember, this is one more type of question. The question is very short, but it is a quadratic equation question. So I think you have already done this. How many of you have already solved the fourth one question? How many of you already solved the fourth one question? Anyone have solved the fourth one question? Anyone? If you have solved, yes. Kirti have already solved. Yes. Nidhi also. Only two members? Only two members have solved. Twisha also. Very good. So like this way, if you will practice daily, you know, it is good for you, so that you can score good marks in an exam. So this here we have consecutive. Remember, mathematical words, we have lots of things. Consecutive, the word says that consecutive positive integer. Remember, here not only one we have word, we have the words combined together. So here first thing is consecutive, second one is positive integer. See, they have combined the two things, and there are two consecutive positive integer. There are two consecutive positive integer means solution. Let first integer positive they have given, so it will not be a negative, so x. So next, second integer we can take it as what? Y. But don't take it as y. Why we have not supposed to take as a y? Because consecutive means what? What is the consecutive number of 5? What is the consecutive number of 5? What is the consecutive number of 5? Yes, 6. Next number. Okay, you are finding the next number. It is 6. Okay, 4 is the previous number. Okay, that is also correct. So here we have anyone, that 5 means 6 we have. So it is next number. So here 5 means this is 5 plus 1. Similarly, here I have taken x, means next number will be x plus 1. So that is called as a consecutive number. So those who have doubt, you can ask me. Those who have doubt, you can ask me. Don't simply sit. This is very important. No doubt. Okay, very good. So next one is very tricky. The sum of whose squares is 365. So what you will do directly, sum of the given. So what you will do, x plus 1 is equal to 365. You will write whether it is correct. What I have written, that is correct. So okay, I will put the bracket for this. What I have written, that is correct? No. Why it is not correct? Why it is not correct? Because they have used the word here, squares. Sum, yes, it is correct. Sum. They have given the word sum. Yes, I have taken the sum. Means I have to add this number and this number. Yes, correct. But they have used one word here, squares. Means here we have a square for this also and square for this also. Yes. So square we have. So x square plus x plus 1, the whole square is equal to 365. That is the equation. Okay. Next, again we have to solve. It is not the end. We have to solve again. Okay, so here we have x square as it is, but this one is in terms of what? What is x plus 1 the whole square? So if I will ask, some student will say that like this way, x plus plus 1 square, sir. No, if you will think this like this way, it is wrong. So next also we have, that is nothing but what? 2x into y. Yes, a plus b the whole square formula. It is in a form of a plus b the whole square formula. A square plus b square plus 2ab. Yes, so x square in place of a we have x, so x square in place of b we have 1, so 1 square plus 2 into x into 1, that is equal to 365. Yes, so next one is, here we have x square, here we have x square, we can add them. So x square plus x square is how much? X square plus x square is how much? 2x square, yes. Some students will write down as a x raised to 4. Okay, it is 2x square. Okay, then plus 1 square is 1 only. And here we have 2 into x into 1 is nothing but 2 into 1 is 2. 2 into x is x only. This 365, how to bring 1 to other left hand side, it will become minus 365. That total is equal to 0. So I have to write it on the exact form. So 2x square I have written first, this 2x square I have written first, then I will write down this 2x here, plus 2x I will write down, and this plus 1, and here we have minus 365, that two things we have to add, but one is negative number, one is positive number, so greatest number having the negative, so negative it is. So 365 is positive, so negative, and 1 is positive, so we have to subtract one number from the other, so 365 minus 1 is 365. That is equal to 0. So this is the thing. This is the thing. Those who have doubt, you can ask me here. Those who have doubt, you can ask me here quickly. It is not 366 because one is positive negative number, one is positive number. Yes. Yes, one is positive, one is negative number. So if it is one positive, one negative, we have to subtract them. So we got 364. And one more thing, make it simple. So here you can see anything is common in this, all the thing, you know, whole this equation, anything is common. So if you will clearly see, yes, 2 is common. So here we have 2, here we have 2, and here we have even number, so it will be 2 common. So take that 2 common. So remaining inside will be x square, here it will remain plus we have and x we have, and here it will remain minus, and 2, how much is 364? Means you have to divide that, divide by 2. 2 ones are 2, 1 will remain, 2 8 the 16, 0, 4 will remain, 2 twos are 4, so 182, yes, 182, that is equal to 0. So those who have not asked me, you have to simplify as much as possible. So next one is simple. This 2, what we have, that have to shift on the other side. It is into in between them. So it will divide. So obviously x square plus x minus 182 is equals to 0 by 2 we'll have. So what is 0 by 2? What is 0 by 2? Quickly, what is 0 by 2? 0 itself. So 0 by anything is 0 only. So it is 0. Okay. So this is your equation. This is your equation. So I will rub this. Okay. Those who have not asked me quickly, why I have told you to simplify means it will be easier for you to find the x value. If you will not solve this, what will happen? It will be difficult for you. Okay. Let us move further. So here we have the equation x square plus x minus 182, that is equals to 0. So if we have like this way equation, if we have like this way equation, and here they have told you to find, not they have not told you to find, but we have to find the x value. Yes, x square plus x. What happened? Here we have taken that 2 common, yes? Here I have taken the 2 common, here I have taken the 2 common, here I have taken the 2 common. Here x square plus x minus 182 is equal to 0. What add? Yes, here it is, as it is I have written, as it is I have written. Okay, as it is I have written. X square plus x minus 182. So now what we have to do, when we will add the number, now if you have a doubt, ask me, huh? Unmute it and ask me. If you have a doubt, unmute it and ask me. So when you will add, we must get 1x. So here we have in the middle term, we have x means 1x. And when you will multiply, we must get this minus 182 into x square, that is minus 182 x square. Okay, then yes, you already know because previously we have done this. Yes, already we have done this previous. That is 3 is not possible, 7. 7, 13 and 13. 1 the, so the 2 and 7 we have to add them, 14 it will be, and 13 we have, so 13 and 14. But remember here, the when you will multiply, it is negative means one, any one number is negative here, not both numbers are negative, any one number is negative, because if we have here this number multiplication, when you will do, if you have here plus, means that both the numbers are positive or both the numbers are negative. If we have here negative, that one, minus 182, if we have that, when you will multiply, we must get 182, no? That it is negative, then we must think that any one of these numbers are negative. So, but here we must get the positive one. So, greatest number will be positive and the smallest number will be negative. Yes, bigger number sign. So, it is positive 14. Yes, it is a positive, that 14 will be positive because plus 14 minus 13 is nothing but how much? Positive 1. Because we must get the positive 1. Okay. If we have the negative 1, the minus will be for the greatest number. If you have a doubt, ask me. Okay. If you will practice, how many times you will practice, that much is good for you. So Ujwala is not answering for the question. Okay. Ujwala, I am seeing from that time you are not answering any of the question. Ujwala is here, yes? You are here, Ujwala? Yes. So x square I have tried on as it is. The 1x what I have, that I have already split it, that is plus 14x. And 1 is minus 14x. Sorry, minus 13x. Minus 182, that is equal to 0. That is the question, that is the answer, splitting the middle term. So next one is this one, you have to group it. Here we have x common and the remaining will be x, and here it will remain as 14. And here we have negative symbol, as it is we have to take it down. Here obviously inside you must get x plus 14. So what you will take it common now? That your remaining is nothing but 13. 13 you have to take it common. So now if you will check it clearly, x plus 14, x plus 14. So x plus 14 you write down here, remaining is x and minus 13. X minus 13, that is equal to 0. So x plus 14 is equals to 0, or x minus 13 is equals to 0. That is the two things we will going to have. So now x value is equals to 14. If you are shifting on the other side, it will become minus 14. And if you are shifting this negative 13 on the other side, it will become positive 13. So which one is the correct answer? Whether the x is equals to minus 14 is the correct answer, or x is equals to 13 is the correct answer. Which one is the correct answer here? Yes, it is. Not both numbers are not correct. Both the numbers are not correct. Both the numbers are not correct. Only one number is correct. Only one number is correct. Because in the question they have given consecutive positive integer. See that. So I am saying that for you have to understand the question properly. You have to read the question properly. So here they have given, if you see the question correctly, they have given consecutive positive integers. Yes. So they have given positive integers. So x is equals to 13 is correct, not x is equals to minus 14. So after doing this, one first number you have to take down as you have to write down in the sentence. So what is the sentence you will write? First number or first positive integer is equals to x, that is equals to 13. Second integer, you write down here, second integer is equals to x plus 1, that is nothing but x value is 13 plus 1, that is equals to 14. So there are two positive integers, one is 13 and next one is 14. Remember, both the things are different because that minus 14 I can't take. Minus 14 if I will take, then x plus 1 will become minus 13. But they have given positive integer, so you have to take only the positive number. So like this way, we have to find the answer for this. That is, x is equal to 13 and x is equal to 14. These are the two answers. Those who have a doubt here, you can ask me quickly. Those who have a doubt, ask me quickly. If you don't have a doubt, we will continue. So when you will have a doubt, on unmute it and ask me. Okay, unmute it and ask me if you have a doubt. Coming to the fifth question. In the fifth question, you can see they have given the word as the altitude of a right angle is 7 centimeter less than the base. So this is all is one sentence. Okay. And next one they have given, if the hypotenuse is 13 centimeter, this is the second statement. Find the other two sides they have given, that we will find later. Okay. Find the other two sides. So what they have actually given here, they have used the word here, one is 7 centimeter, hypotenuse is 13 centimeter they have given already, and altitude of the right angle triangle 7 centimeter less than its base they have given. So what actually they have mentioned here, which thing you can apply, which property you are applying over here. So see, this is the question, is a quadratic equation, but actually yes, you have to go through the triangle lesson again. You have to move to the triangle lesson because it's a right angle triangle. So whenever the right angle triangle word it will come, no, it is a Pythagoras theorem. Yes, so it is a right angle triangle. So one more important thing about the right angle triangle I will tell you. Hypotenuse we have, that is 13 centimeter, that they have given, and one height they have given. Height refers to what? Do you mean by height here? Height refers to what? So here ABC we have one interesting thing about the right angle triangle. Here height refers to what? Whether height is AB or height is AC. How many of you think the height is AB and how many of you think the height is AC? Okay, I don't want that value. I'm asking about which one is the height here. Whether the height is AB or AC. Okay. Actually, only one girl is correct here. Only one girl is correct. That is nothing but both. Yes. Depending on the base, we can take any of the height. So, if you will consider this is the base, this AB if you are taking as a base, height will become the AC. If you are considering this is the base, the height will become AB. Remember, because this triangle similarly I can draw like this way. So, it is A. It is B and this one is C. See, I can draw the same triangle like this way. So that time the perpendicular is AB, now this will become the height and base will become AC. So both the things are possible in right angle triangle only. In any none of the other triangle, it is only for the right angle triangle. Both the things are possible. So here what they have given, that I will write it down. So first one, okay, solution. Okay, I will write down here solution. Hypotenuse. First I will go for the hypotenuse. Hypotenuse equals to 13 centimeter. That they have given. And base, they have not given here base. So let base is equals to. So here they have given the altitude. Altitude is nothing but the height of the right angle triangle, 7 centimeter less than the base. So less than the base here. Okay, one more thing regarding your English knowledge I want to know. So here in this statement, what they have in the statement, here they are comparing something to something else, no? So they are comparing the two things here. Which, what they are comparing here? Actually, what they are comparing to what? So very important in mathematics, it is very important. So yes, they have comparing the altitude. They are comparing the altitude with the base. Okay, the base and height they are comparing. But what they are comparing? The altitude. See here, altitude of a right angle triangle is means I have already told. Is means what? In a previous class, linear equation class, in the last week also I have told you. Is means what? What do you mean is? In mathematics, is means what? I have already written that. What do you mean by is? Altitude of a right angle triangle is. This is, yes, that is nothing but equals to. So when it is, that is called equals to. So altitude is, means A is equals to 7 centimeter less than the base. So 7 centimeter less than the base. So they are comparing with the base. So base is here. 7 centimeter is less than the base. So it will go reverse way. 7 you have right at the end. And it is less than what? The base. So it will be like this way. A is equals to B minus 7. If you are taking altitude as A and the base as B. But we will take the base as what? X. So here it will be X minus 7. So what is the altitude will be? What is the altitude will be? By statement. By statement. Altitude is equals to base minus 7. 7 centimeter less than its base. Yes, that is X minus 7. So altitude is equal to x minus 7 we found. So this is the main thing what we need. So if you understood this much, we can move further. So those who have doubt, ask me. So everything is based on the statement. Remember, everything is based on the statement. If you will understand the statement, it is good. If you are not understanding the statement, it is not so. It will be difficult for you. So I have taken the base as x. The altitude will become 7 centimeter less than the base, means x minus 7. Any doubt? Yes, you can write down the altitude plus 7 is equal to base. But what will happen? You have taken the base as x, yes? So it will be not possible afterwards. So what will happen? A plus 7 is equal to x. So it will not be correct. Again, you have to shift that 7 on the other side. But if you will take the altitude is equal to x, then it is proper. If you are taking the altitude is equal to x, then it is proper. I am talking to Kirti, okay? So, don't get confused again. If you are taking the altitude as x, then you can write down a plus 7 is equal to. Okay. So, now the next statement. Next statement means next one. Find the other two sides. How you are going to find now? So, you will apply what here? Which property? It is right angle triangle. Which property you are going to apply? Which property you are going to apply? Pythagoras. So, by Pythagoras theorem. By Pythagoras. So it is directly you can write it down, or I will take little bit down. Okay, by Pythagoras theorem, here you can write it down the triangle that is BC square. I think you hope you know that statement is Pythagoras theorem. Square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares of the other two sides, that is AC square plus AB square. So BC is 13 square, that is equals to AC is here x minus 7 the whole square plus AB is over here x. So here we have x and here we have x minus 7. I think you understood this, yes? So next I will take little bit again down and how to simplify this. So 13 square is equals to 169. This is in a form of a minus b the whole square. So x minus 7 the whole square, it is in a form of a minus b the whole square. So it is nothing but a square plus b square minus 2ab. So what will happen? X square. Next 7 square is nothing but 49 and minus 2 into 7 into x. So x square plus 7 square minus 2 into x into 7. Okay, so here we have x square into 7 square is 49 and 2 into 7 is 14 into x plus x. So here you have square, okay, x square. Yes, very good Vidya. So this is the thing. So anyone, if you have a doubt, you can ask me. So those who are not understood this step, ask me quickly. Here I have done this one square property I have applied. A minus b the whole square property, that is over here. So here you have x square, here you have 7 square, 7 square is nothing but 49 and 2 into 7 is 14 into x is 17, 14x minus 14x. That plus here we have x square, so that x square I have written as it is. Those who have doubt ask me, otherwise I will continue quickly. Okay, x square plus x square, how much? X square plus x square, how much? X square plus x square, 2x square, yes. Then we have minus 14x, so I will write on minus 14x. Here I have plus 49, so plus 49 I will write. And this 169 I will shift towards the right hand side. It will become minus 169 and here it will remain 0. Because I have shifted that minus plus 169 on the right hand side. So it will be negative 169, okay. So you can understand it, I think so. So if you have a doubt, ask me, no problem. Yes, so 2x square I will write on as it is. Okay, that is equal to 0. I can write it at the first also, last also. Minus 14x I will write on as it is. So now it is having some trouble over here. It is, one is positive, one is negative. Greatest number sign is negative, 169 is the negative. So negative will be the sign will you are going to have. Very good Vidya. So next one, in 169 we have to minus 49 because one is positive number, one is negative number. In this case we have to subtract. So smallest number is 49, you have to subtract from 169. So 169 minus 49 is nothing but 120. So this is your equation. Okay, it is not 129, 120. Okay. So next step, what I will do is this total thing I will write towards the left hand side. And this 0 I will write it on the right hand side. It is will not become any change you are not doing. Okay. So it is simple that everything what I have on the right hand side, I have written the left hand side, and 0 is left hand side, I have brought it to the right hand side. So those who have a doubt, ask me quickly. If you have a doubt, quickly how to ask me. Doubt? So this is the equation which you found. But actually again you can do something else over here. What you can do? Okay. I want the answer from Ujwala. Common, yes, you can take the common. So what is the common you can take, Ujwala? What is the common you can take over here? 2, very good. So 2 we have to take as a common. Then here it will remain x square. Here we have 14, so 2 how much of 14? Minus as it is, 2 sevens of 14, 7x. So 2, 6 are 12 and 0 we have, that is equal to 0. Okay. Okay. So next one, we have to shift this 2 on the other side. It is into in between, so it will divide. So it will remain only x square minus 7x minus 60. That is equal to 0 by 2. 0 by 2 is nothing but, already I have informed you, 0 by 2 is nothing but what? A 0. Yes, 0 by 2 is nothing but 0 itself. Okay, so next one is nothing but the splitting method. We have to use the splitting method and we have to find the answer for this. X square minus 7x minus 60, that is equal to 0. See how much simple question it is, but it is becoming lengthy. Lengthy answers, yes. because if you are very good in calculation, it will go very quick, otherwise it will take time. So splitting the middle term, when you will add, you must get minus 7x. When you will multiply, you must get minus 60x square. So this one, minus 60 into x square is minus 60x square. When you will add, you must get minus 7x. So okay, Nidhi already found that answer. Very good. So 60, we have to factorize it. 2 30s are, 2 15s are, 3 5s are, and 5 1s are. So 60 can be written as 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. So grouping, first I will tell you the product is negative. So one number is negative, not both the numbers are negative, only one number is negative. And it's having the negative symbol for this one also. So you have to remember one number is greater and one more number is smaller. So grouping is very important. 2, 2 and 3, 5 it will group 15, and 4 it will be 3, 5 to 15 and 2 to the 4. But we are not going to get any 7 from this. 15 and 7, 15 and 4, we are not going to get the 7. If you subtract also, we are going to get 11 only. 15 minus 4, if you do, that is 11. So it is not possible with this group. So we have to change the group. Yes, we have to change the group. So changing the group is very important. Here I will group as 2, 2, 3 as 1 and 5 as different. Yes. So 1 is a 12, 2 to the 4, 4 is a 12, and 1 more is 5. So 1 is 12 and 1 more is 5. If you subtract 12 minus 5, you are going to get 7. So greatest number must have this negative. So 1 is minus 12x, 1 is positive 5x. Okay. So next, splitting finished, that we will write it on, in place of minus 7x, we have to write on minus 12x. And here I have to write on positive 5x. Minus 60 is equals to 0. So now we have to group this two. Okay, who is left here now? Just know who is left. Russell, you are here. Several members you have left here. Who have left now? Several members have left. Russell have left. Okay, one more. I think Prajwal and Russell. Okay, next one is nothing but here you have to group. So x and x, x is common, so here it will remain x minus 12, and here we have 5x and minus 60 in that positive we have as it is, we have to keep, and 5 is common, so x minus 12 is left, that is equal to 0. So if both the side we have x minus 12 and x minus 12. So x minus 12 you have to write on that side, and x and plus 5 you have to write on one side. That is equals to 0. So here I think till here you understood. So here x minus 12 is equals to 0 separately you have to take, and here I have to take x plus 5 is equals to 0 separately. That is or in between. So x value is positive 12 and x value is negative 5. That are the two numbers we found. So which one is the correct answer? That is most important. So this they have given. Yes, one is positive, one is negative. Here they have given side of the triangle, side of a right angle triangle. Okay, so this is 13. So x is this one, and this one is x minus 7 we have taken. So here one thing is clear. This is A, I think this is B, and this one is C. Base, what we are going to take, it must be a positive value. It must not be a negative value. It must be a positive value. So x is equal to 12 is the correct answer. So therefore, base of triangle is equal to x, that is equal to 12 centimeter. Altitude of triangle is equal to x minus 7. So x value is 12 and minus 7, that is equal to positive 5 centimeter. So we found both the things. Yes, we have found the altitude as 5 cm and the base as 12 cm. That is our answer. So this is the fifth one question what we have. Actually, it is a simple one. It is not a difficult one. It is very simple question, but you have to understand it. Yes, let us move further. Yes, very good. So here article produce I have taken as x. Cost of the articles I have taken as y is equal to 3 plus 2x according to the statement. And total cost I have taken x into y is equal to 90. Next it will become x, and y value it is nothing but 3 into 2x okay, and that is equal to 90. And 3x, x you have to multiply for both, x into 3, 3x and 2x square. Then I have brought that 90 on the other side, it will be minus. So all of you might have got this answer. So after this splitting method that you know already, that is nothing but splitting the middle term. So you must get the 3x when you will add, when you will multiply, you must get minus 90 into, okay, here we have minus 90 into 2x square. So it will be not this one, minus 90 into 2 is 18, so 80, 180 x square. So 90 into 2 is the 180, 180 x square. Yes. So what are the two numbers? One number must be negative because the product we got here is one, minus 180. So one number is negative, one number is positive. So greatest number must be positive. See, positive 3x we have, so greatest number be positive. So 180 splitting, 290 is the, 245 is the, 315 is the, 35 is the, and 51 is the. So if you will compare it correctly, these are the two numbers. Directly we can say 2 to the 4, 4 3 is the 12, and 3 5 is the 15. So 1 is 15, that is the greatest number is a positive 15x, and one more is 12x because 15 minus 12 is 3x. So here I can write down that 2x square I have to write down as it is, plus, sorry, minus 12x plus 15x minus 90 is equals to 0. Common thing over here, this 2 and x, so remaining is your x, here it will remain 6. Here this common is 15 because inside it must be x, 15 into x is 15x, minus 15, 6 is 90, that is equal to 0. So grouping this equal terms, x minus 6 and 2x plus 15 is equal to 0. So x minus 6 is equal to 0, 2x plus 15 is equal to 0. These are the two things all you have to write down in between. And next one, the x value is 6 and 2x is equal to minus 15. When you shift this 15 on the side, it will be minus 15. Then x value is equal to minus 15 by 2. So x value, which one is the correct answer? So anyone will say that in our factory we have produced minus 15 by 2 articles. Whether you are, you can say that minus 15 by 2 you found the articles in your factory. No, it is not possible. So positive value, that is x is equal to 6. Therefore, number of article is equals to, articles is equals to 6. Cost of articles is equals to 3 plus 2x is the equation that we have found already above. No, here you can see 3 plus 2x, we have found that already. So 3 as it is plus 2 into x value is nothing but 6. Okay, this is x, that is equals to 6. So 3 plus 2, 6 is 12. So 12 plus 3 is 15. So number, cost of article is 15 rupees. And the number of article is 6. That is the final answer. So hope everyone have found this answer only. And maximum of you have found this answer only. I think so. Anyone with a different answer? Anyone with a different answer? No. So if you have found it with the different answer, you can see it to me. So this is not the difficult one.